How could you let me down like that, Brian?
Oh, I let you down. Why? Because I refused to demean myself by perpetuating the stereotype of the good dog?
This was the one thing I ever asked you to do for this family. Well, you know, this and not do that thing when you drag your ass across the carpet.
Oh, one time I did that. One time.
Peter, Brian, please. Let's just have a nice family car ride like we always do.
Yeah, except for the time Dad hit that deer.
Yeah, looks like it's just a ding. You know, there's no reason to get the insurance companies involved.
Well, you know, I should still take down your information, though.
Really? Because, you know, you could probably just buff that out.
I would really feel better if I got your information.
Meg, honey, are you okay?
Yeah, I think so.
The Quahog cable television transmitter. Uh-oh.
Hey, you just knocked out cable TV for the whole town.
Oh, boy. Hey, look, there's Bigfoot.
Whoa. This isn't about me. This is about you.
Oh, well, at least that bought us some time.
Beautiful country, isn't it, Chris?
God, it is peaceful. No question, Dad.
Just be careful, because I got a lot of big old wilderness bugs out here.
Oh, hey. Y'all best be careful or I'm gonna sting you with my stinger. Oh, no. But then that's gonna die if I sting you. You know what? I'm not gonna sting y'all after all. And that's my choice. Y'all ain't worth it. I'm just gonna head on over to that flower and suck on that stamen like there's no tomorrow.
This is unbelievable! Well, I am not gonna stand by while you let this town be destroyed by corruption. Mr. Mayor, I promise you this. Next election, I'm gonna run against you. And I'm gonna win.
All right, Mrs. Griffin, you want to take me on? Fine. But if you plan to beat me, you'll have to...
What is it?
A bee just flew in through the window. Don't move.
Now look who's mayor. First order of business. Free honey for everyone. Yay, Mayor Bee, Mayor Bee, Mayor Bee. Ow! Oh, done stung myself. Bye, world.
Where am I? Grandpa? What are you doing here?
Chris, welcome to the Skull and Bones Society. This is where the most powerful men in the world are groomed for their futures. Every president, every CEO, every douchebag named Ryan Seacrest. The Skull and Bones Society has been a part of my family for decades, and we want you to become a member.
Really? Wow, cool!
Excellent! You get your own stock portfolio, a percentage of the 9/11 Victims Fund, and the best medical care on the planet. You'll be kept as healthy as a horse.
So, how's that leg doing?
Great, never better.
Good. Why don't you try putting some weight on it?
Sure! Yes! Oh, that's good. That feels good. Very strong.
Sorry, Thunder. I gotta put you down.
How's your leg, huh? How's your leg? You ready to race, huh?
You have a point, Griffin. Maybe we should run a company-wide check to make sure all our personnel are legal citizens.
Now you're talking, Angela. This country needs more immigrants like my cousin Peter the Pig needs a new house.
I wouldn't do that if I were you.
What?
I said I wouldn't do that. I said knock it off!
Why?
Because I just made stool in there, and if you blow it down, the whole woods is gonna stink. Do you understand? Do you understand me, sir?
Now, Mr. Swanson, through the magic of digital imaging, we'll select the legs most suited to your body from our inventory of donors.
Hey, what about these?
Ah, good choice. These are the only ones we have in stock that aren't hilarious.
I'll take them.
Joe, you are going to be happier than bullfrogs on vacation in Ethiopia.
Oh, this is fantastic. This is even better than they said it was in the brochure.
Oh, yeah, I feel like a pig, but come on, we're on vacation.
Exactly. Right. Don't hate yourself. We're on vacation, right?
Yeah, I hear Madonna's raising this guy's kid.
We now return to Julia Louis-Dreyfus in Now It's Just Getting Sad.
Okay, hear me out. My character is a therapist living in the city, but I'm married to an elephant.
Hi, I'm the husband.
Hey, honey. We're going to my parents this weekend. Did you pack your trunk?
I don't think I want to go. I don't like going to your parents.
Why?
Maybe because your dad's an ivory hunter?
See? There's a lot going on here.
A lot going on. It actually gets pretty watchable.
Howdy, new neighbors. Pleased to welcome you.
We're the Lynches. We live next door.
Nice to meet you. We're the Griffins.
Nellie here is a homemaker, and I'm a queer chaser and beater.
Lois, I'm not sure this is the right place for us. These Texans are socially backward, and politically they're all stubborn as a mule.
Nope. Sorry. Kevin Bacon wasn't in Footloose.
What? Of course he was.
No, he wasn't. You lose.
Of course he was. He was the star.
Nope, you're wrong. Look it up.
I don't have to look it up. It's common knowledge.
Nope.
He was on the cover of People magazine when the movie came. Everyone knows Kevin Bacon was a star of Footloose.
No,
it was a huge movie. He was the lead.
No.
Hey, guys, thanks so much for inviting me out today. I'm psyched to brand my first cow.
Here you are, Peter. All fired up and ready to go.
Oh! Oh, yes! Yes! Oh, hang on a second.
Man, Texas is great. Horsey, you saved my life.
No problem, Peter. Glad to help out.
Wow, Gilbert Gottfried!
That's right!
Awesome.
Peter, I don't think...
Shh, it's Daddy.
2 and a Half Men was filmed in front of a live ostrich.
Boy, this stinks. It's Friday night and I don't have a date.
Well then, let me get you a number from my little black book.
Ha ha! Oh God, hey listen, you guys get to know each other. Looks like my doorman let another gazelle in here. I'm sorry, but we've been over this before. We don't serve your kind here.
You're gonna hear from my lawyer.
Yeah, you know, I would welcome that. I would welcome the opportunity to hear from a lawyer that represents a gazelle. What's his name?
Yeah, I don't have a lawyer.
As long as he's a part of that family, there's no place for me.
Well, I can't say I blame you. I hate him as much as you do, Brian. He's a bad fit, like a crocodile at an alligator rally.
Yeah! Lurking in the water with our eyes poking out!
Yeah! Yeah!
Sneaking up on a crane or an egret and snapping our jaws on it!
Yeah!
And sometimes walking out onto a dry plain or dusty field because it's nice to get out of the swamp now and then!
Yeah!
Wait, what? Huh?
Dry plain? Dusty field? Nice to get out of the swamp? What a crock!
And that's where we get the term.
From now on, buddy, you're the only animal I care about.
Hey, everybody! I'm Bernie the Hamster! Would you like to be my friend? Oh, my God!
It's okay, Peter.
Yay! Oh, my God! Oh, my God! It's a hamster!
Come on, guys. Let's head over to my crib.
Hey, you guys mind scooting over a little bit?
Ooh, sorry, Peter. Doesn't look like there's any room.
What do you mean?
Well, there's only one space left, and I promised it to that cow.
This is gonna be so much fun. I'm gonna stick my head out the sunroof and wave my arms and go, woo, I'm in Hollywood! Woo, I'm in Hollywood! See, I said I'd do it!